Hi guys, this is Aisha Joshi and you are watching me on Achieve IAS. So today we are going to discuss about some military exercises. See what is happening, we all are busy in discussing about COVID-19 and all the situation of India and country and all over the world even. That what is happening about COVID-19 and all. So in between that, we are skipping so many important topics that are important for our exam point of view, or I can say this is important for our knowledge also. So here today we are going to discuss all about the military exercises. Recently some military exercises has been done and it is all about 2020 even. So here we are going to discuss all about 2020 exercises. So first of all, I would like to welcome you on behalf of Achieve IAS. So if you like the video till end, be with me because we are going to discuss the most important topics that will be definitely important. These topics are very important for our exam point of view, whether you are going for some UPSC or state services or SSC, no matter what type of exam are you preparing for, you have to go through all these recent current affairs topics. Okay, so here we are going to discuss about recent military exercises of 2020. Let's go through it. The first exercise is India UK joint exercise. It is the fifth edition of the exercise of Indradhanush that was commenced on 24th Feb 2020. Okay, so it is the addition of Indradhanush exercise, that is military exercise, and this is the joint exercise of India and UK. It was held in Hindon. We will go through it. It is a joint air force exercise between the Indian Air Force and the Royal Air Force of United Kingdom. So it is important here that this exercise is a air force exercise. It is in between Indian and Royal Air Forces of United Kingdoms and India. Okay, so what are the key highlights of it? The exercise focused on basically base defense and force protection. Okay, so around 36 specialized combatants of the Royal Air Force participated in this exercise, and from the Indian side, 42 combatants of Garud Commando Force participated in this exercise. Here what is important, that the Royal Air Force of British included 36 specialized combatants, but here the Indian Royal Army, or I can say Garud Commando Force, included 42 combatants. Okay, so the exercise was held in Hindon Air Force Station. What is Hindon Air Force Station? The Hindon Air Force Station operates under Western Air Command. It is the 8th largest airbase in the world and the largest airbase in Asia. It is located in Ghaziabad, Uttar Pradesh in India only. So here it is important also, because this exercise was done on Hindon Air Force Station, and this station is the largest airbase of Asia, and even if we talk about world, it stands on 8th largest position. So here where it is in Ghaziabad, UP. Okay, so it was about Hindon Air Force Station. Now let's go through the Garud Commando Force. Here we discussed about the Garud Commando Force of India. So what are the Garud Commando Force? The Garud Commando Force was formed in September 2004. The force is mainly tasked with the protection of air bases and installations, disaster reliefs, search and rescue operations during hostilities. So all these works have been done by Garud Commando Force, and this was formed in September 2004. Okay, they are currently deployed in Congo to fulfill United Nations peacekeeping operations. So what are they deployed for? Peacekeeping operations in Congo. Okay, so here it was all about the Indian UK joint exercise. Let's go through the winged radar. What it is? This is the army's largest airborne exercise. The troops that were participated in this exercise were approximately 500 troops were included in winged radar. Okay, So what was the conducted area of it? It was conducted in Northeastern Theater. What about it? The exercise was conducted to demonstrate the operational readiness of the paratroopers and air warriors. Okay, the C-130 Hercules, Dhruv helicopters and C-17 Globe Master transport aircraft participated in the exercise. Which were the aircrafts that were participated in the exercise? That was C-130 Hercules. Other than this, Dhruv helicopters. Other than this, C-17 Globe Master transport aircraft. Okay, these were the major aircrafts that were included in this exercise. Okay, so the exercise was telecasted live. It was the exercise that was the light that was covered the live telecast. Okay, it focused on encountering China in the border region. Iska main focus jo tha, the focus of this exercise was about encountering on the China on the border region. Okay, in the border region, the exercise also included capacity building programs and habitats. It also focused on moving certain advanced weapon system to the eastern side. So what it is, the exercise included the capacity building program and habitats. Along with that, it focused on moving certain advanced weapon system of the eastern side. Okay, so here you can see the picture of it. This is the picture of winged radar. This was the exercise that was done. This was the air exercise, and approximately 500 troops were added. So you can see here some troops are visible in this picture also. So what is the significance of this radar, winged radar? The army is preparing itself to act against threat posed by China. You know very well that China is a country whom which we are continuously, there are some barriers, I can say some misunderstandings, some I can say military issues, some border issues, all the types of issues are going on with this country. Okay, India is suffering a lot with this country, and China is continuously, as you all know that COVID-19 is also a part of or initiative of China. We don't know it, whether it is intentionally or not, but here it is the initiative of China, we can say. That was I hope it was unintentional. So here it is not the focus point of us. Focus point is winged radar. So the army is preparing itself to act against threat posed by China, and Indian army is also developing infrastructure in the eastern border. Eastern level of borders is not that much matured, and for that the infrastructure is bit weak in that area. So Indian army is focusing to develop the infrastructure in our eastern borders. Along with that, these exercises help to self-assess the readiness of the troops. What is the basic situation or what is the condition of our troops? This will also be assessed by this exercise. The exercise will also help army to rebalance its western and northern fronts. So by this exercise, army will also rebalance the western and northern fronts. So it was all about the significance of winged radar. Okay, so let's go through the next. Here it is Him Vijay. What it is, Him Vijay is also a similar exercise, okay, that was conducted in Arunachal Pradesh in October 2000. Why we are discussing it? It was conducted in October 2019, and it was conducted in Arunachal Pradesh. This was Him Vijay. Okay, it was also the same exercise, at it was winged radar. Why we are discussing it? Because there were some lapse in this Him Vijay exercise. That's why we are conducting winged radar. It was a mountain combat exercise. The exercise tested the integrated battle groups, IBG, okay, in Indian Army. The IBG consists of tanks, infantry, air defense, logistics and signals. All these things are consist in IBC. I mean, IBC consists of all these things. So it this exercise tested the IBG in Indian Army. Okay, it means this exercise will conduct the or test the tanks, infantry, air defense or logistics or signals, everything. Okay, related to Indian Army. The IBG is a restructure combat tactics of Indian Army. This helps to meet emerging threats in the eastern border. So here we are facing so many threats regarding China in our eastern border. By this Himvijay exercise, our Indian Army tried to resolve all these issues by testing IBGs, integrated battle groups. Okay, it was conducted in October 2019 in Arunachal Pradesh. Arunachal Pradesh, the easternmost area of India, and or we can say the part of Seven Sisters. Okay, so the exercise also helped the India Army to learn lessons. By this Himvijay exercise, Indian Army learned so many lessons. According to the feedbacks of Himvijay exercise, what were the feedbacks of it? That communication skills of the army should be developed. When this exercise was exercised, or we can say Himvijay was exercised, at that time when the feedback was taken by this total assessment, then we get that we can say the Indian Army should be developed in communication skills basically. Other than this, we are very strong, but communication skills are still weak. And after that, we go through winged radar, or I can say the recent exercise, Indian UK exercise. So all these exercises are different, and the motives and the productivity of all these exercises are different. But here I can say that Himvijay was also a lesson for our Indian Army. Okay, so it was all about the exercises that were done in recent military exercises that were done in recent time. Okay, so here in between COVID-19 and all these things and lockdowns and all, we are our focus on all these things are less, so we have to go through other topics also. We have to go through some important app schemes and total exercises, or I can say the total assessment of all our exam or current affairs should be done. So here by this time you can use your time. Hope you all are staying at home, hope you all are taking care of yourself, and hope you all are obviously you should have to be concerned about what the instructions are given by our WHO, or I can say the Indian government, because our government is doing so well. We are in good hands, so we have to cooperate with them, and hope you all are doing this. So in this particular video, we learnt about the military exercises. This was the India UK joint exercise, that was Air Force exercise. Then we go through the winged radar. After that, we go in through the Himvijay. So by all these exercises, we learnt a lot, and these were the major exercises that was done recently. By along with that, we will also go through the major exercises that were done in 2019, because all those 2019 exercises or I can say apps or schemes or government initiatives or current affairs are very, very important for any exam of us. Okay, so hope you all get everything that we discussed in this video, and hope you all are going to cooperate with government and cooperate with our Indian public or Indian police, Indian doctors also, because this is necessary. Right now we are in this condition that we don't want, actually we don't have that much equipment so that we can arrange that type of issues and that level of issues. So be safe, be at home, be stay home, and always spend this precious or beautiful time with your family in learning more and more about what you are going to prepare for. And always be there with me, because I am going to go through I will manage all these current affairs to cover, and I will definitely discuss all these current affairs with you. So be with me, and subscribe this channel, like this channel, because by subscribing these channels, you will definitely get every recent video or recent activity of mine, so that you can be aware about it. Okay, so thanks for being with me. This was Aishu Joshi on the channel of Achieve IAS. Okay, bye bye, take care, stay home, stay safe.